Now, for the velocity analysis, let us consider omega A be the angular velocity of the input link, and then omega B will be the angular velocity of the coupler link, and omega C will be the angular velocity of the output link here. Okay. So, to do this velocity analysis, again let us consider this equation, the displacement along x-axis, that is equation 1 as well as equation 3, that is a cos theta plus b cos beta is equal to d plus c cos phi, that is the displacement along x-axis, and displacement along y-axis is a sin theta plus b sin theta plus b sin beta is equal to c sin phi. So differentiating this displacement along x and y axis, we will be getting the velocity equations. So to know that, we have to rewrite this equation 1 and equation 3. So rewriting equation 1 and 3, can write it down as a cos theta plus b cos beta minus c cos phi minus d is equal to 0. So let's take down this equation as equation number 1.1 or something. Okay, or you can take this thing as equation number 12. Okay, so differentiating this equation, equation number 12, differentiating with respect to time. Okay, so let's differentiate d by dt into a cos theta plus b cos beta minus c cos phi minus d is equal to 0. So to differentiate, basically we have theta over here, so it is not possible to differentiate in this manner. So to differentiate this, let us write this equation as d by d theta into d theta by dt into a cos theta plus d by db into d beta by d theta into b cos beta minus d by d phi into d phi by dt into c cos phi minus d by dt into d, so that is equal to 0 here. Okay, so let us consider d as constant over here and differentiate this with respect to d theta. So differentiating a cos theta with respect to theta, what we get here is, so differentiating that, we'll be getting it as a differentiation of cos theta is sin theta minus sin theta, and the differentiation of the angular displacement or angular position of the input link, that is d theta by dt, will be omega a. D beta, differentiation of beta with respect to time, will be omega b, and differentiation of t phi, that is differentiation of phi with respect to t, will be omega c. So this equation can be written as differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta, so it will be written as a omega a sin theta minus b omega b sin beta plus c omega c sin phi. that is equal to 0. So let us take this equation as 13. So this is a very important equation. Okay, so let us take this equation as 13 here. Now similarly, rewriting the equation, that is the displacement along y-axis, equation number 3. In equation 3. So what we get here is a sin theta plus b sin beta minus c sin phi is equal to 0. So let us take this as equation number 14. So differentiating this equation with respect to time, again differentiating with respect to time. So what we get here is similarly what we have got over here. So we'll just differentiate and see. So that will be again d by d theta into d theta by dt to a sin theta plus d by d beta into d beta by dt into b sin beta b minus d by d phi into d phi into d phi by dt into c sin phi is equal to 0. So differentiating sin theta with respect to theta, we'll get it as cos theta. So we'll get the equation as equation will be a omega a cos theta plus b omega b cos beta minus c omega c cos phi is equal to 0. So this is equation number 15. So this is also another very important equation here, these two equations, okay, 13 and 15. So next up is multiply equation 13 by cos beta and equation 15 by sin beta and add. When you multiply equation 13 with the cos beta and equation 15 with sin beta, what we get here is, just write it down, that is a omega a sin theta to cos beta minus b omega b sin beta into cos beta then plus c omega c sin phi into cos beta plus a omega a cos theta to sin beta plus b omega b cos beta into sin beta minus c omega c cos phi into sin beta is equal to 0. So simplifying this equation, you can write this equation as so here omega b and this thing both will get cancelled. Okay, so these both will get cancelled, and simplifying this again, we can write down this thing as a omega a into sin beta cos theta minus cos beta into sin theta minus c omega c into sin beta cos phi minus cos beta sin phi is equal to 0. Okay, or this can be written as a theta a into sin beta minus theta minus c omega c into sin into b minus phi, so that is equal to 0. So we can put this on the other side and we'll get the equation for omega c, that is equal to a, so this is omega, sorry, not theta, omega a sin beta minus theta divided by c sin beta minus phi. Equation 13 by cos phi and equation 15 by sin phi and add. So equation 13, that is minus a omega a sin theta into cos phi minus b omega b sin beta into cos phi plus c omega c sin phi into cos phi plus by sin phi, that is a omega a cos theta into sin phi plus b sin beta into sin phi sin phi minus c omega c, that is cos phi into sin phi, is equal to 0. So these two will get cancelled out. So we can write down this particular equation in a simpler form, that is a omega a into sin phi cos theta minus cos phi into sin theta plus b omega b into sin phi into cos beta minus cos phi into sin beta is equal to 0. So again we know that sin a minus b is sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, so this thing can be written as a omega a sin of phi minus theta plus b omega b sin of phi minus beta, so that is equal to 0. So we'll get the expression for omega b, that is equal to minus a omega a sin phi minus theta phi, okay, yeah, divided by b sin phi minus beta. Okay, so to calculate omega, so this is the question 17 we can consider. So this is the angular velocity of the coupler link here. Coupler link, okay. So to calculate the angular velocity of coupler link as well as the output link, the necessary magnitude that are required and vectors is the magnitude that is A, B, C and D, and the angles that is phi, theta and beta and omega A. So all these things are required to calculate the angular velocity of coupler as well as the output link here.